Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and it's great to have your company here for the first event of this Junior World Cup here in the beautiful Sydney, Australia. You join us for the 10-metre air rifle men's junior event at the formidable International Shooting Centre in Sydney. My name is Danny Potts, and I will be, it's my pleasure to lead you through today's finals. But luckily for me, I am not alone, as my guest today is Jamie Webb from Australia. Jamie, thanks for joining me.
Thanks very much, Danny. It's just an absolute privilege to be here. Just to share in this event today and to see these really top quality shooters.
Yeah, it's great to have your company. We'll hand you over to Jamie Strangroom, who is our announcer just now, and we'll introduce you to our athletes, our final eight for today's competition after the qualification. So I'll hand you over to Jamie right now.
To the Sydney International Shooting Centre. The final competition for the 10-metre air rifle men's event will now begin. So let's meet the athletes. On the firing point A, representing the People's Republic of China, he competed at the Junior World Championships in Seoul last year, and his Asian Championships gold to his name is Yan Changhong.
Only 18 years old, 1 month and 2 days to be precise. Let's not do the ages.
B, 2 days. Representing the People's Republic of China, and also appearing at his first ISSF competition. So let's give a Sydney welcome to Liu Yuqi.
16 years old.
The quality of these athletes.
And moving on over to firing point C. Also representing the People's Republic of China, and also making his international debut, another debutant in this final is Fu Gangfeng.
Yeah, 18 years old. Yeah, it's very good to have these sort of competitions,
now
isn't it?
The,
these junior competitions give them an experience of finals, so when they sort of become seniors, they get used to the whole atmosphere.
Yep. Asian Championships last year in Waco City, taking the bronze medal away with him. Give it up for Shahu Tushamane.
Another 16-year-old.
On the firing point E, representing India, he's no stranger to a Junior World Cup, taking bronze at Gabalar in 2016 and finished fifth at the Seoul World Championships last year. It's Arjun Babuta.
He's the oldest of the group at 19.
And he shot very well in qualification this morning too.
Moving on to firing point F, representing Singapore. He's competed at 3 Junior World Cups, and today is appearing in his first final. So please welcome Mohammed Kwan Abdul Rahman.
And Rahman's 18 years old.
Keep an eye on him today. He was shooting great groups this morning.
On firing point G, representing India. The 16-year-old is appearing at his first ever competition, qualifying at a first time of asking for a final. It's Surah Pratap Singh.
Yeah, it's great to see Pratap here. Only 16 years old, like I say on the profiles that we get given. Not even got a photograph at the moment, but great to make the final.
Representing Hungary, he's won Junior Euro Championships silver in the free positions and the 50-metre prone of gold. Appearing in his first final at a Junior World Cup is Salan Pekler.
Pekler, only 18 years old as well.
And
so there we are, there's the lineup. Like you say, Jamie, you were at the I saw you in the qualifications there, so you saw a lot of these athletes shoot, and you were saying that
that
Rahman was shooting very well, but also Zhang qualified first. Who have you got sort of, if you're a betting man, who do you want to put your money on?
I thought Barbuda was going to take out the highest score in the qualification this morning, then just his last couple of shots just went down, but he shot a series of 10.9, 10.9, 10.8. Wow. I have never seen so many 10.7s through to 10.9s when he gets going in a string. So if he can handle the pressure of this final and keep the heart rate down, keep the tension down, I'm sure that he'll do well.
But it's really important for these athletes that if people are tuning in at home and they're not used to watching shooting before, it is all about the heart rate, it's all about the breathing, all about that sort of, that's the main sort of technique that you're taught, is it? Because you're a coach as well, do you say?
That is correct, yes. I do train juniors up in Toowoomba in Queensland, as well as do some Level B International ISSF judge for rifle. And we're down here on a coaching course just to specifically look at the international athletes and the international coaches and how they coach. And certainly one thing that we've seen over the years is when it's one thing to go through the qualification, and I can speak from personal experience here a little bit because I like to shoot in the Oz Cups and that sort of thing. But when you walk out onto the finals range, all of a sudden you get this heartbeat that wasn't there before, and you get this feeling that just runs through your body that you didn't have before, and all of a sudden the sights just start jumping to the heartbeat.
Yeah.
And that's, I think that's the big battle when you first start shooting finals. But then as you get into the finals, and these guys will have most of these people will have shot finals over time, they start to get used to the pressure.
Yeah, exactly.
That sort of thing.
And it's all the music's now been added and things like that, isn't
correct?
It? So it's
yes,
all different elements, and then the announcing whilst you shoot, you know, that type of stuff.
That's right. It's been a big change over the last 10 years, going from virtual silence
yeah.
to let's make as much noise as we can and have a bit of rock music and...
Some interesting choices in certain countries as well.
So another one bites the dust, I think, in the,
yeah,
as we get into
think,
the eliminations. By Queen?
I think it was in Rio when Shotgun's just about to start. They played the diddle now, now, now. You know, the Spaghetti Western or whatever.
Oh.
What was that? But anyway, here we go with today's final. Yep, just so you know, there'll be two series of five shots now, each fired in the time of 250 seconds per series. This is followed by 14 single shots, and they have 50 seconds per shot. Eliminations begin after the 12th shot and continue after every two shots until bronze, silver, and gold are decided. But let's see who's got off to the best start here. 10.7 for Fu. It's all about getting the scores on the board early, isn't it? And giving yourself the best chance, because those single shots, it's
yep.
that's where everything really starts to change. So if you start scoring high and then really give yourself the best standing.
That
the
is
final.
Correct, yeah. It's very hard to pull it back. If you have a bad start, just with the way the finals are set up now with the decimal scores, if you don't have a good start in the finals, you're really pushing the wheelbarrow uphill trying to get there in the
I
end,
like
so
that.
To speak.
I'm getting a lot of these Australian sayings down now. I got I like the wheelbarrow up. Yeah, 10.6 for Liu. 10.7 for Rahman, shooting very well. He's currently in first place in Singapore.
Rahman did very well this morning in the qualification too.
He qualified second after Zhang of China. So what do you think about the sort of increase in terms of shots in these series for the piston rifle? Could it used to be two three-shot series, didn't it? Now it's 2 5-shot series. Do you agree with that?
I do. I think the five-shot series is good because it gets an athlete, it gives them an opportunity to show their quality.
Yeah.
You know, you might have one that might not be as good as what you would like, but then you've got four other shots. You know, you can really sort of settle yourself into a series like that. Put distractions out of your mind and just concentrate on the job at hand.
Exactly. And that's what you mean. Like, I think you see a lot more changes as well, because it's such, you know, those first ten shots, if you give yourself the best chance there, I mean, you can really separate yourself if everyone else isn't shooting that well. And then the single shots, there's less pressure there. Obviously, there's always pressure.
Correct.
But a lot of the time, you see people leading quite a lot of the way, all the whole competition. Like Zhang now, obviously, first and second place at the moment, and first and second in the qualifications.
Yes.
So they'll be keeping that form. You know, they've got their eye in at the moment. I know it's a change to the finals range, but they've got their eye in, and then it's just trying to keep that rolling on to the finals, isn't it?
That's correct, yeah. You will see the good shooters just rise to the top in the final, as always in most situations. Just for the viewers at home too, they're aiming at a black spot that's about 33 millimetres across. That's the black, but the bullseye that they're trying to hit is only half a millimetre across.
Yeah.
So you're trying to sort of touch that, or preferably obliterate, the hole of the centre of the target with the pellet. The pellet's only 4.5 millimetres across. But yeah, you're aiming for a bullseye that's half a millimetre across. If you have a bit of a heartbeat, it's hello eights, here we go.
Exactly. Heartbeat or bad eyesight, isn't it?
Stop. Hello, what have we here?
So there we are. Zhang is in first place. Rahman is in second at the moment. Liu is in third, joint with Main. But yeah, 0.3 separate Rahman and Zhang at the top. Towards the bottom of the table is Pratap of India, 2.1 off joint sixth position, Peklar and Fu at this moment. But everything can change, can't it?
So. It can. Tie for third and tie for sixth.
Yeah, exactly. This is how close it is.
This format of finals is just so exciting to watch.
And there's so many teammates in here. Obviously, we've got three from China, we've got three from India, Do you know what I mean? So they'll look across, they'll know how strong her fellow teammates are, yes, as well, you know. So there's that added pressure as well, that they train together, they shoot together, and they'll know that if they give themselves an inch, you know, these people will just jump in and sort of take the lead ahead of them.
A lot of these juniors here, they would be able to hold their own in a senior World Cup, I'm sure. After seeing some of the scores that were shot this morning, it was a real privilege to sit there and watch them shoot.
Exactly. It's so great when you see these juniors go on to great things as well. Like Isfan Penny, he went to, he's now world number one, but was a junior not so long ago.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
And he was a rifle shooter. And they must also see people doing so well like that and get inspired. And that's what it's about, giving that sort of inspiration to young shooters. It's all about getting youth into the sport, isn't it? And
it
we
is.
Want to promote this sport, and that's why we do these live streams. That's why we do the Facebooks and Twitters and social medias, the things that I don't understand really very well. But
I reckon it's just marvellous. You can have a person right around the other side of the world, 20,000 kilometres away. They can sit here and they can be part of the action here in Sydney. It's just amazing.
Yeah.
It's wonderful.
And it's great to have your comments. So at home, please tweet in. Please leave messages on YouTube. Please share the video, because that's when we want to promote this sport as much as possible. So Zhang, now still in top spot at the moment. Rahman has moved down into third. And Pekla has jumped up into second at this moment.
I was watching Pekla shoot this morning.
Yeah.
And he went through the majority of his match. He was shooting one shot every 24 seconds. And they were pretty reasonable pins he went through. It was just fantastic to watch. He's obviously got a great routine there. He's got a very upright position. You can see the differences in position between the different nationalities. The Indians seem to have a position that they have. You can instantly recognise them on the range as being an Indian shooter. And likewise, the Chinese, you can recognise that the Chinese, they have a very particular position that they shoot with well. They seem to have their feet perhaps slightly closer together than a lot of the other athletes, and the majority of the Chinese also have quite a big back bend to get their balance. It's all about balance with the rifle. They're not trying to hold it with their muscles.
Yeah.
They're just allowing the centre of gravity just to sort of sit there, and they should nearly be able to take their hand off the pistol grip, and the rifle should not move at all.
So is this something? So that's very interesting. So it's mainly countries that have their own style more than the athletes having their own sort of shooting style.
Yeah, obviously there's variations between that. But it was just one thing of part of the coaching course we were looking at this morning.
No, it is. It's fine. Well, everything you just said, I was looking at, and you're absolutely right.
Mm. You should have a look at the two Hungarian athletes, Pekla and the young lady who's currently shooting qualification. Their position is very similar. It's a very upright, almost what you call proper type position.
Yeah.
The Singaporeans, they have their feet close together as well, but they pull the rifle right back to them, and they seem to have a very relaxed looking position.
There we are, there's the second five shot series. And Liu has now jumped up into first position over Pekla, who's the new second position from Hungary. Only 0.1, look how tight that is at the moment. 0.1, 0.1, 0.1. Spinning all those athletes from first until fourth.
That is so close, isn't it?
So close.
1.6 points between first and seventh.
Yeah, and then down in, and then down, like saying down in sixth and seventh, they're only 0.1. And then
Prato. I wonder if we'll have some shoot-offs for Ty.
I know.
As we go in, very exciting.
I know, I do like seeing that in pistol rifle. I really do. Because all the I find the decimal very interesting as well. I find it a lot more interesting to sort of talk about as well, and everything is so vital and crucial. Every it's not hit or miss. It's, you know, these percentages.
How deep
I love
the team
that.
You can shoot.
And you see the pressure. You can really see the pressure affects them. You know, someone can be shooting very well, and they know the cold's on the line, and they can just shoot nine or something like that.
Oh, I even saw one of the Chinese shooters. He shot a 10.1, and he was unhappy with himself.
Oh, really?
I mean, that's the standard that they're at. He was averaging like 10.5 for every shot. It was just wonderful.
Have you seen much of a difference? Obviously, you know, you've been in the shooting sport for a long time, so you must have seen things change differently. Have you seen scores change as well? Have you seen sort of the quality of athlete rise as well? Or
I think if you compare it to the 100 metres in athletics, for instance, you see the performance levels of the athletes rise over time. They just keep lifting and lifting and lifting, and to incorporate those changes, the ISSF, they change rules, you know, every Olympic cycle every 4 years, and they've now got it decimal because a lot of people were shooting equal scores with just straight raw scores, so now we've got the advantage of having computerised targeting systems where you can pick it up to, you know, 0.1 of a millimetre sort of thing, and the people, they just keep lifting and lifting with the quality of the score. So I think over time you always are seeing incremental improvements in the quality of athletes across the board.
So here we are, this next single shot will decide 8th position in today's final.
Star.
Partop currently in danger, 1.9 off safety at this moment. Let's see what he can shoot here. Pepper with a 10.3 and 8.8 for Rahman. It's not like him, he's 10.5 for Main, that's very good. Caught up with a 10. And it will be Pratap that leaves in 8th position today.
So ladies and gentlemen, 8th place has been decided, and representing India, it goes to Surya Pratap Singh.
Yeah, Pratap Singh, only 16 years old. It's but great to be in a final. It's all experience. Yeah, that's
absolutely
what it is.
Just fantastic opportunity, and he has just done so well this weekend.
So we are down to 7 athletes now. No change at the top in terms of the leader. Still Zalman Pekler got a 0.6 lead now over 2nd place.
Yeah, that I can't remember now, but in the 8 ring there, Rahman has dropped him down into 6th position from 2nd, and that's how big the lead can be.
That's right.
You know,
one bad shot,
yeah,
and you go from rooster to feather duster.
I need to write these down. Rooster to feather duster. Love that.
Star.
Here we go, 2 more shots, and then we'll decide 7th position. And that's how it carries on. So we decide that gold medal that we're all hunting for.
Still, the gaps are so close between all the shooters. Gang Feng Fu, he's in 7th currently. He's only 1.5 behind Rahman.
Rahman, 10.8. that's the reaction you
10.
Want.
10.7 from Fu. Look at that. That's quality shooting, isn't it?
Especially with that pressure being down at the bottom of the table like that, and then to really pound on the pressure with a 10.7 and a 10.8. 10. 10.6.
Stop.
Yeah, so he's closing the gap, Fu.
Lovely high scores there all round.
Rahman's jumped up into 5th from 6th. But then at the top of the table, that lead's getting less. Liu chasing down Pekler now, 0.3 between them two. Again, just consistent shooting.
But the next shot will decide 7th. So as I mentioned, Fu looking to chase down.
And that's not even half a millimetre in a shot. Yeah, that's what that score is. It's just so minute, the 0.3 between 1 point. It's talking fractions of millimetres that are separating these shooters.
Start.
Many viewers at home as well, they may think about the suits that they're wearing.
Yes.
You know, it's something, if you're just tuning in, it's quite an alien thing to see. You wouldn't expect, you know, but it all helps, doesn't it, with the sort of...
It does. The first thing that people ask when they come to a range to learn target shooting, and they see somebody with the target shooting jacket and the target shooting pants, and they say, is it to protect you from the bullets?
Yeah.
You go, no. No, we don't have any of that sort of stuff here, thank you. But what it is, it's made out of a very stiff material. It has to comply with the rules. And the idea is it gives the athlete a great deal of support as they stand in position. So you've got to remember the qualification match is 60 shots, goes for over an hour. You're trying to stand still for a long time.
Yeah, it's Fu Gangfeng in 7th place there.
Yep, so all the gear that you can see them wearing there it helps support the body, it takes out the vibrations, it helps them to be steady. In particular, for standing shooting, having the shooting trousers, that's very good. You need that to support your back as well.
Yeah. Especially with the positions that you said, some of them are further back and things like that. That really takes its toll on the body.
Yeah, so some of these guys, they must be doing some real stretching and Pilates and that sort of thing. And people say, target shooting, you're just standing there doing nothing. But it's the sport where you're not trying to move. And these guys that are shooting at this level, they are doing the same amount of training as an athlete that would be running for the 100 metres. They're just doing a different sort of training. It's you've got to have your balance. That's the foundation of everything. And your muscles are not holding the rifle. You're not trying to activate any muscles. You're trying to just relax and let the weight of the rifle just sit down there so you can sustain that accuracy without movement for well over an hour of shooting. And then you come into the final and you've got another half an hour of shooting here.
Exactly.
Stop.
That's when you see, obviously, the three positions as well. That's when you see them change parts of their suit and change parts of their clothing as well. But that's even a longer competition, isn't it? So that takes you in a long amount of time. So it's an endurance sport as much as it's
shooting a three-position match, a 3x40 match. That's about the equivalent to running a marathon, I reckon. Here we go. After all these shots, we've got a tie for second.
Yeah.
And those two people are only 1.1 behind Peckler, who holds first position. He is shooting so well. 10.7 on the last shot.
He's found himself in first for quite a while now, hasn't he, during this final?
Just extending his lead slightly.
So it's Lane that's currently in danger down in sixth position, but only 0.7 off safety. Rahman from Singapore in fifth. Peckle again with a 10.4, a few nines there. 9.8 from Rahman, 9.4 from Main.
A couple of nines starting to creep in there.
That is the two athletes that are at the bottom of the table, so maybe the pressure's getting them to a little bit. Babuta with a 10.8. Wow.
That's fantastic shooting, isn't it?
Ladies and gentlemen, taking a sixth place, representing India, let's hear it for Shahu Tushamane.
Oh, Mane, so I've been calling him Main, forgive me. Mane.
Finishing up with 161.7. And then there were five athletes remaining in
each individual athlete must be taking a lot from this final because the scores are so high that it's not that they've shot badly. That's what they need to remember. It's not that they've shot badly. It's just because the scores are high, the pool of athletes is very high. So it just means that it's just a difficult competition. It's a difficult lineup, you know.
They had the top qualification scores this morning, 624, 623. There were several on that score. Fantastic to genius.
So, yeah, Peckler still leading the way, going into shot 17. And the athletes in the medal positions at the moment, Peckler in the gold position at this time. In second place is Zhang, third place is Liu.
Tension starting to rise now.
Here we go. There's Babuta on the screen. 10.8 for his last shot. He didn't carry on that form.
We'll let 10.7. Don't know if that'll be enough to save Rahman.
Great, 10.6 from Zhang.
High scores all round and a big 10.7 for
Rahman. So 1 point separates Rahman in fifth from fourth Babuta.
Himself and Babuta, his
rival, is now so close, it's so hard to call, but Peckler still leading that way, still fighting out for that gold. Does look very calm out there. It's interesting to see the athletes which take their time with their shots and the athletes that shoot quicker.
Yes.
It's all individual preference, obviously.
Peckler was the quickest shooter in qualification this morning, and Rahman and Babuta were probably the slowest. I think they finished with only 2 minutes to spare. So each athlete's obviously got a different style and a different setup as to how they approach the match. Peckler seems to have himself a good routine when he shoots. He gets himself into position and shoots all within 24 seconds nearly every time.
They are 9.7 from Peckler. Might give the others a little bit of a chance to catch up slightly.
See what James shoots here. Will it put him into first place? Tie?
Tied? Yes. Yeah. You called the ties. We might be seeing that for gold later on. But yeah, Rahman shot very, very well there, taking fifth place.
We'll see big things of him, of Rahman, in the future. I've got no doubt about that.
I've seen him around the range. Actually, he seems quite a warm character, quite a smiley, smiley guy as well, which is always nice to see. He seems very happy with himself. He was in danger a few times, but then always saved himself with a high 10. So, well done to Rahman.
Shows a good bit of mental dedication to get in there and just keep fighting on like that.
So, after two shots, we'll decide that that fourth place, that unfortunate fourth place that you've come so far and so close to one of the steps on the podium.
Yep.
But unfortunately, taking nothing home, unfortunately. But
0.7 between first and fourth. 0.7 of 1 point. And as they say, anything can happen.
Exactly. Star. There is the leader, Peckler. 9.7 in his last shot. Joint the Zhang. Like Jamie was saying, very quick shooter, so he may shoot first. And he does. Yeah,
10.0.
Ooh, nice, 10.7 from the Babuta.
That's quality, isn't it, in the final?
Just forget how young these athletes are. You just forget, you know, you're watching this competition, it's just like watching, this, like say, a senior event.
There we go, three-way tie for second.
Wow, and that's it, that's how it changes. Zhang has now jumped up to first. Babuta, Liu and Peckler all joint second, 0.2 off that cold spot. Now this next shot, this has got to be hard now, because they're all joint, they're all so close. If you take that fourth, it's so unlucky. So if there's any time to score high, it's now.
Yeah, focus on the Hungarian coach there. He's looking a bit nervous.
It would be unfortunate, wouldn't it, for Peckler to leave with nothing after such a great performance. Let's see if he can hold his nerve. 10.0 with his last shot. It all comes down to this. Ooh, not bad, 10.5.
That's not bad. It's not bad. Let's
it is beatable, though.
He shot first. Oh,
10.6.
Oh, 9.3 from Zhang. Oh, wow.
Wow, from first to fourth.
So, ladies and gentlemen, finishing in fourth place with a total of 205.1, representing the People's Republic of China is Jan Chang Hong.
Wonderful effort from him today.
Great, finishing top in qualifications and then to come here and to shoot like that. But what a shame going from first to fourth there. But, you know, he shot very, very well indeed. Here we are, we have our medalists.
We do.
These are our medalists. It's time to decide which athlete takes which medal.
And you don't get really, you're looking for gold, silver and bronze. You do not get any closer than this. You got 0.1. separating three shooters as we come into the last few shots of the match.
Babuta now the new leader. Liu in second. Peckler also joint second. Show must go on.
So sometimes Mr. Music, he has to really put in a bit of creativity here to select these songs in the finals, I think. It's very artistic. Peckler with an excellent 10.6.
Boots at 9.9.
There you go. 10.7 for Leo.
He's now in first position. Peckler in second, still only 0.1 separates second and first. And down in third is Babuta. So jumping from first to third, we're just seeing changes all over. You know, people from top to bottom, from bottom to top. It's just so close.
That's what makes this new format of finals so exciting. It's fantastic.
That's next shot decides who takes home that bronze medal.
Start.
Psychological and mental training these guys must have just to be able to put everything out of their mind, focus on the job at hand, just to keep everything still in a very nervous position.
Patola 10.0. Babuta with a 10.2.
From Liu.
Ladies and gentlemen,
there you go, the bronze medalist.
Medal representing India goes to Arjun Babuta.
And a well-deserved medal that is too. He has shot so well today.
Welcome to Arjun. He can add that to the bronze he took in Kabbalah back in 2016.
Yeah, Babuta, yeah. So like Jamie's just saying, bronze in Kabbalah, the Junior World Cup. And now another bronze here, so congratulations to him. That heavier luggage on the way home, I guess. Heavier hand luggage.
A little bit more excess baggage.
Exactly. Not bad excess to pay for. So here we are, the final two athletes fighting it out. Peckler in second position and Liu in first. 0.7 separates the athletes as we go into our final two shots of today's Junior World Cup.
Peckler shoots first with a 9.7.
He knows that he might have given Liu a bit of an advantage there. I really see Liu's distinctive style of shooting, like you said there, but far lean back on the screen.
Oh, there we go. What a way to finish. 10.7.
So 10.7 for Leo Yuchi is.
Here we are, 1.7 separates the two athletes. And only one more shot separates one of those athletes from that gold medal. Liu with the advantage.
See, Liu Yuchi was just giving himself a little slap on the cheek there after that shot there, just to encourage himself. You see on Peckler's rifle there, he's got some weights that are stuck onto the rifle to get the centre of balance in exactly the correct position.
And there the crowd.
Yes.
We'll have to take something quite unusual for Liu to drop down now, but
he holds his shot for so long, doesn't he?
Especially because Peckler shoots so quick.
Nine point zero. Big smile on his face. Exactly. Look at that, isn't it lovely?
I was going to say, we're just waiting for the. I thought something had gone wrong there for a second. A bit of silence before we announce the gold medal, but there you are.
Yuchi
with the gold medal. Congratulations to him. He's thrilled. Lots of support here for him today. And Peckler with the second, with the silver medal. Shot very well throughout the whole competition, didn't he? I mean, he was always at the top of the table. Dropped down a few times, but very consistent. Such composer.
Very well deserved.
Brace yourselves to release noise from your hands and mouths.
Just Jamie's doing a marvellous job doing the commentating.
Some alternative commentary there. Winners. Well, yeah, once again, here they are. Here are the winners of all the medals today at our first event. We have one more rifle event today, the ladies' turn, after this, and then we're going over to the shotgun range for our third event of the day. But Paputa takes home the bronze.
Love the smiles on these faces.
Yeah, exactly. Representing Hungary, it's such a great opportunity for them, like I've said throughout this, and then to take home a medal as well. It's just that icing on the cake.
That's right. Yeah, one thing I like about the target shooting community is that the majority of people are really, really friendly, very welcoming, and a lot of the shooters are good friends between themselves as they meet each other at the various competitions around the place.
That's it. They go on tour. They basically go on tour together, don't they? So when it's so nice when you see them greet each other and think that there is no sort of hard feelings. And you know, the initial opinion you get when you first see a shooter is they're always very composed, so they can look quite serious.
Yes.
And as soon as you start talking to them, their face changes completely and they lighten up. And
that's correct. Yeah. They can sort of switch on and switch off, can't they, in between the shots.
But thank you so much for tuning in today. It's great to have your company, and we hope you tune in for our next finals. It's only our first day here. We've got a few days left, so please tune in. And like I said before, please share these videos, promote these videos. We love the shooting sport. We know you do too, because you're tuning in. If it's your first time viewing this, we hope you enjoyed the sport, and we hope you tune in again soon. Thank you so much. My name's Danny. I've been joined by Jamie Webb. Jamie, thank you. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Thank you very much for the privilege of being able to be here and just share this first event of the Junior World Cup with you. It's
exactly
wonderful.
And you're off to the Commonwealth after this.
Yes, we'll be up at the Commonwealth Games starting on the 4th of April. It's going to be wonderful.
Great. Good luck with all that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, everybody, and we'll see you soon.
The bronze medal representing India goes to Arjun Paputa. And the silver medal, representing Hungary, goes to Salan Pekla. And the gold medal, representing the People's Republic of China, goes to Liu Yuqi. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the People's Republic of China. Let's congratulate the winners of the 10-meter air rifle men's junior event one more time. Arjun Paputa, Salan Pekla, and Liu Yu.